Okay, Grace DeMarco is shooting this video, but you have a very special day in your household, you and your lovely bride, Cheryl, because on this day, 2 years apart, two daughters actually celebrated birthdays.
Yes, they're 26 and 24, Alexa and Jessica. When they were born, I was an assistant for when Alexa was born. We beat Finley here in an upset. Coach Sullivan had the greatest quote and it made the paper. He basically said, hey, we'll have a baby every week if it means winning a game. And then Jessica came 2 years later, and we played somebody that week. And yeah, I'm blessed.
Hey, U.S. News and World Report, regional universities, right here, Geneva College, voted one of the best and also best value. That's an incredible, I think, honor.
Kiplinger, a great magazine, looked at all the private schools in the country. And I'm talking like CMU, Case, the Ivy Leagues, all these prestigious private schools. Geneva finished 70th in the country. And that is pretty prestigious on value.
Absolutely beautiful campus. Always enjoy coming here. Well, the GT's total offense, 541 yards. Don't say triple option that did that for you, because that's impressive no matter how you look at it. 493 yards rushing. Wasn't enough, though, against Carnegie Mellon, 42-27. Lost now 3-3 overall and 2-2 in the President's Athletic Conference. Down 14-0. I hate to make you go through this again, but it's what I'm not being paid for. Okay, here we go. 14-0 in the second quarter. Trey Marshall runs for 77-yard touchdown, then it's 14-7. Carnegie Mellon, they struck two more times in the quarter. Brian Stafford connects, made it 28-14 going into the locker room at halftime. CMU put another touchdown on the board in the third, making it 35-14 in the game. And then Harrison Koslow, 26-yard scoring run, made it 35-21. Rory Hubbard, this was the, well, folks, the proverbial end of the line in this game. 92-yard kickoff return.
Yeah.
That was huge. Final 42-27. Let's talk about this football game, then I'm going to break it down a little bit for you. Go ahead.
Well, Koslow was the young man that had two touchdown passes, receptions. And, you know, we had 490 yards on the offense on the ground. Mm-hmm. But we had a missed field goal, two fumbles, just because the young man was trying to make plays. And we had another fumble. So we had four inside of 25. You can't win if that happens. But our kids, I think the game gave our kids some confidence offensively, because Carnegie Mellon is a really good football team. And, you know, we're getting better, Rob. We really are.
Special teams, defense, obviously the scoring was there. What about some of the parts of the football game, those 60 minutes that just weren't working for you, you thought? I mean, well, 42 points is 42 points.
I mean,
still.
Yeah, they score. Obviously, you can't give up a field. You can't give up a
92
return. Yeah, that was just, it just can't happen. And it won't happen again. We had actually four guys on that kickoff team that missed the game that week. So, not making excuses, but it was a great impact. That kickoff, I think, turned the whole game around. And we missed a field goal, bad snap. You know, it is what it is, football. You can't beat yourself. I mean, we can beat one team. We can't beat two.
All right, now look, Saturday night right here, Reeve Stadium, beautiful scenery, best place to be to watch a football game. They have got Case Western University, 7 o'clock. Now, last week against Teal, 49 points in the first half.
Yes.
28 points in the second half. They win 63-28. They are 6-0 overall, and in the same conference that you play in, they're 5-0. I would have stopped and picked you some Pepto-Bismol up, but you know,
we got them right where we want them,
Coach.
They're a juggernaut.
Yeah,
they're a juggernaut, and we're just a small group from Beaver County that's just, you know, honored to be on the field with him.
Rob Kuda, senior quarterback, first half only 343 yards passing and 5 touchdowns. They just basically sat him in the second half. And then Jacob Burke, 514 yards rushing on the year. Zach Hurd, 120 yards receiving, 562 on the year. So they've got talent. What do you do to stop, as you call them, a juggernaut like that?
You keep them off the field. And to keep them off the field, you run the clock, you run the football, you hold on to the ball. And, you know, our defense just, we're getting better. We got a young defense. That's what people don't understand. And we're just going to keep people in front of us.
All right, as high school football season winds down, a lot of student athletes out there wondering what the next step will be. Many of them want to play college football, and there are a lot of them that I'd love to see come here. What's your message to them? Just the thought process and why they should at least think about paying a visit to college here.
I think what we offer at Geneva is a total person concept. I mean, we can talk athletically about making them better football players. Academically, you come to college to become a better student. Mm-hmm. But I think the spiritual component on what we do with our kids, because we're a Christian school and we can base it on Christ, that we talk with these kids about leadership, what it means in life. And it's just not confined to those 4 years. It's confined to the next 40 years of their life. So that's why when we get these alums that come back and they are making an impact out in the world, it's because Geneva College creates that kind of environment. And not every kid on our team or every kid on this campus is a Christian, but this is who we are, this is how we go about it, and it helps because we have an identity. And today in higher academia, there are many colleges that are struggling with what are we about, what's our identity. And for us, we know who we are. Mm-hmm. We know some people aren't coming. Okay. We also know that what that finished product is, and we just thank the Lord that I thank the Lord I can coach in this kind of an atmosphere. That's the message.
Mr. Nesmith invented the great game of basketball using peach baskets, as in produce peach baskets, in 1891 in Springfield, Massachusetts, and then in 1892, a little intramural game here, the first ever on record, right, as far as college basketball. This is my thought process, and I know you've known me a long time as you squint your eyes. Where is he going with this? I think every week that I leave here, true story, how many people I've known and athletes and families and generations have finished some sort of workout or practice at Matheny Fieldhouse or at Reeves Stadium, of course, and a fall night, fall air, getting dark early, heading back to class, dormitory, home, wherever. It's astounding to think the body of work, the people that have climbed up those steps at the end of an evening here on this incredible place that is on College Hill, Geneva College.
It's a heritage that many people really don't understand. As one father said on a recruiting visit, he looked at me, and he was from right outside of the county. He said, "This is a diamond in the rough." He said, "This is the best kept secret." What a place! And the finished product. And when we talk about the friends that we know that have come here, and what they're doing in life, it's like I said, it's a blessing to be here. Saturday night we're gonna have to find a way to stop this quarterback, and all will be good.
No doubt. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much, as always, for joining us, and the place for faith, family, great education, and some sort of camaraderie that you won't find anywhere else, Geneva College. Your Pratt Pack saying good night.